Sir, 5 cents to call now.
Okay. Between 1 and 50.
Yeah, well, sorry.
28.
Unless they go halfway and stop start from the other end.
I know your mom and dad. Did you see Jeff Whitmore on TV? He was one of the judges for, I think, Miss America or something. He was one of the judges. No, he was one of the judges.
He's a pointy fella.
We
oh, man, look at that. I ain't better with you anymore.
Now, Mike, he doesn't get Tuesday with anyone.
Huh?
Joe didn't think she'd give her a piece of pie.
He's not.
He's married.
Is he?
Mm-hmm.
Hey, Eddie, let's go slam your face in it.
Now, Chrissy, you know you can't eat dessert. You've got a place to
put it. Hey, let's get a picture of Grandma.
Make sure you get everybody.
A great cab.
No, we'll just go back to Christy.
I gotta make a copy to take
that. You'll
be able
to see her. That's a colored lens, remember?
She didn't even hear me. I heard
you. Stop
talking.
She's got to like the healing. You missed it, Mike. Mm-hmm. I told Joey, he said, well, we just turn back to Christian, said you won't be able to see her. That's a colored lens.
I got selective hearing.
It's a good thing.
You're really cool, aren't you?
Okay, I think I've breathed it out. Time to go back to the cheesecake.
Pause the camcorder and go in and get
everything. Oh,
now, I was right in the middle of dessert.
Hey, Jess. Wave high.
They bite.
We bite.
There's Uncle Mike's chest.
We're going to slap the prettiest girl in the world.
Oh, man.
You guys will all be mad at Patty at the end.
That's Edwina.
Eddie's hard at work.
You got the ice, didn't you?
That's selective hearing, too.
Yeah, he doesn't hear me at all.
All men have that.
What?
Don't get mad when Patty wins it.
Don't worry.
That's best looking.
Still ain't like home.
This is my first year up in
Hey, stay out of Bellbrook Sunday.
I need some.
What's in Bellbrook?
Jenny?
KKK
having a we'll pull you over.
Oh, he's riding with the pastor Sunday night on his plane.
You got mine.
It fits my head, so I'm wearing it.
Hold on.
Do you have...
This one's mine.
Where's mine?
I got to play it.
Where is the music? I've asked three times.
I don't know where it's at.
Oh,
yeah,
y'all.
It's in a black case. Where's the other hat?
Word, mock my mother.
I got one on.
I'm so sexy.
Where'd you grab him from?
I'm so sexy. I love that movie.
Wait a minute.
Mary.
Oh, yeah.
This
yeah,
is one. Al's.
What? He's
going to be taking my hat.
Don't put mine on. I love
mine. Have a holly jolly.
Wear it and like it.
I got
to
look in the mirror.
She's got a thing. There's another hat in there.
She has a holiday scarf I put on her.
Well, in my house, we do.
We don't look good with that hat on.
There's another one in there.
Whoever wants it, Greg, why don't you put it on?
Well,
oh, yeah, I will. Or you can have mine and I'll wear that one.
Got on with Pitt Gray.
Well, I don't want to wear the one that Robbie wears.
Yeah,
be
in
right.
Here,
dude.
Wouldn't be right to Robbie.
He ain't here.
You just squashed the lights, Joey.
How'd you step over
him? No, you didn't. You stepped on him.
He's probably thinking of
it. He asked me how I had the tree up there. I said, yeah, it ain't decorated.
Jingle bell rock.
Yeah. I love
it. Joey, I want the soundtrack.
taking off his hat.
Joey. I'm saying it with a bill.
What do you want, Mom? Which ones?
Usual ones. I think you called out my parking lot.
I had out your karaoke time.
Supposed to be in the freezer. Hey, Jim, you when you're done there, you gotta go get you an Allie's med.
He's in his uniform. He's all good. Business.
Craig, is this a new fashion look?
Huh?
Is this a new fashion look?
What's that?
The hat.
I'm Santa with a bill, man. I'm Santa with a bill in a complex.
Just hand it around.
I'm just kidding.
Oh, don't worry, I have Joey. Allie, these are not the
I didn't mean to be praying.
Well, these are some. We have them with
Well, I'm going to start a new tradition here.
What?
Santa with a bill, you know. Robbie will say...
Santa Quackers.
He'll say, ooh, he looks cool.
Wait a minute, the camcorder, everybody, because I'm going to take this down to Robbie.
And you talk about me. I got the sick one, Greg.
Roses! What they do in the street corner, they get this one guy and say, Roses! I say roses! He said, I get here, I don't need a hearing aid. He said, roses! Then the guy jumps backwards. What about him? Trying to sell him, yeah.
Heck, man. Away.
He drove
away. Yeah, he's worried about me, Joyce. I don't think you, it's me you got to worry about.
He drove about all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
All right, is going to do the lights outside today?
Nope. Ain't going until I get back.
We ought to make a copy of this Christmas video here and then tell it to Edwin. Hey, Juanita. Hey, Ed. Merry Christmas.
You know, just for Robbie this year, I'm not going to do what you think I'm going to do.
What do you think, Wendell?
Oh, I think you better make two pots.
You know, people have never worked out for public.
Especially
when you see it.
Every year on Christmas, Robbie thinks I'm going to pull down my pants.
Guess what?
These are like a little thing on the bottom of the bag on.
birthday cake.
See this? Birthday this goes cake. Around the tree branch. And it locks like that.
The bottle
right there. So go around the tree usually about the midway down. And the bubble. When they get hot, they start bubbling. The bubble lights.
I still got all the old Christmas records that my grandmother had, you know?
Yeah.
Like
hey, who's
stuff,
over here sitting not doing nothing?
It's me.
Boy,
good. All these bubbles.
Oh, God, he's killing me.
Oh, girl. Oh, my God.
Like, yeah, so what do you do? What do you do?
that money I gave you.
Is there a blue moon on this song?
He looks like a dirty cotton swab. Then I realize he's just my flesh and blood. And then it's like, all I can say is, oh my God. Don't blame me. It's the way he looks. Looks like he was hit with a truck and then was crushed with a book. But all will be okay. Tomorrow's a new day. Walking in the winter wonderland.
Joey, do we need sugar in the tea?
Song's over with now. I can't say that. Stop there! Bring it on! Yeah. I am helping.
Doing what?
Before I got Yay.
Go, you see him, Rudolph. She says, eat, Santa, eat. You got all year. For one Christmas to the other.
Wait till that was the
animal, honey. You can start doing the back. These are Joey ones. Joey, did you make this or was this made for you? No, I think Aunt Marilyn then made it in 1990.
Why can't you run farther than me?
Oh, he's checking it. He's
checking it
twice.
The art rip was made for me.
They make it personal, Greg. We make our Christmas tree personal with personal artifacts and things like that, but they won't let me put mine on there.
Dad, you can't be the ornament.
They don't want me to put pork chops on the tree.
I made these in 1976.
My baby the sewer.
Ever since.
Your what?
Raggedy.
My baby the sewer. She sews just about anything.
I was a newlywed. We couldn't afford a lot of ornaments.
She sews everything.
You want this up there too? Or is this some kind
of an ornament?
There ain't nothing on it. You'll have to find it.
I'm going to put these on the fire for you. I'll set these on Monday. They're so heavy, they bend the branches. Here, Joe. Here's one for the babies for Christmas. That's yours.
You need to get a hook and hook the center of the
cell. Is there any hooks?
Yes, I have a thing of hooks. Where are they at?
This requires a hook.
It might not, wouldn't it?
No, we could just have Greg stand there.
We do have hooks, Greg.
Christmas is over with.
Make it line up so it looks like the Statue of Liberty.
Yeah, Greg,
go. Joey, get down there and look, and there's a box of green hooks, and there's silver ones. Jim, you're not going to be able to do this during the holidays.
Got my
hand to
the
aggregate. There comes St. Nick breaking the tree, watching as he breaks my leaf.
too fat for any white.
Yeah. like up and down and up and down.
Like that?
Yeah, go all the way around.
Okay.
It'll be a deep strike.
You can't get it.
We'll be delighted. I like it.
Where are we staring at,
Joe? Just going underneath the gold one.
Oh,
you guys are off now.
The stars are brightly shining.
He was listening to Jim Neighbors sing, what was that song he says?
Smiling nephew Fred from the center of the room.
Bah! Humbug.
growled Scrooge.
What are you doing here?
He snarled at Fred.
I've come to invite you to our Christmas dinner tomorrow, Fred answered as he patted his uncle on the
arm. I got a great guy to get the other.
I won't be there, said Scrooge. Great. Christmas is a day just like any other. And we'll be working. Cratchit's eyes fell to his desk as Fred put his arm around Scrooge's shoulder. Nonsense, he said proudly. We'll be looking for you, Uncle Scrooge. Everyone needs his family at Christmas. As Fred left, Scrooge went to his desk where he spent the rest of the day counting his money long after dark. He looked up at Cratchit. I suppose you want to go home now, he complained. Sir, about it tomorrow. Oh, stay home if you must, Scrooge growled, but be back before dawn the next day to make up the time off. Cratchit grabbed his hat and bounded for the door. Oh, thank you, Mr. Scrooge. Thank you very much. Scrooge was still frowning as he walked the cold, shadowy streets toward his home. Cratchit needs to be more like Jacob Marley, he muttered. He raised his collar against the wind. Marley kept his money for himself, instead of giving it others to waste. As he walked up the front steps, Scrooge reached for the handle, glanced up at the door, and gasped. The familiar lion head door knocker was now the exact image of Jacob Marley. Scrooge trembled as he yanked open the door and rushed into the house.
You want this over?
And locked the door behind him.
No.
Raced up the long stairway to his bedroom. He fumbled with the match, trying to light the lamp in his room, and then he heard a sound of heavy chains clanking and clanking and clanking past the door, up the stairs, and outside his room. Who's there? Said Scrooge. He backed up until he tripped and fell onto his bed. The chains came right through the wall, wrapped around a gray ghost whose chalky face looked just like the knocker on Scrooge's door. Marley, Scrooge gasped.
Give me a hammer and a small nail.
Yes, Ebenezer, it is I, the ghost of Jacob Marley, said. I have come to warn you, Ebenezer, you need not live or die as selfishly as I did. Scrooge shivered.
How's that, Mom?
You must listen to every spirit you will
meet tonight. The angel looks like she's got too much to celebrate with.
Said Marley, the ghost of Christmas past.
Great, can you help me out with the angel, make sure she doesn't look like she has too much to drink?
You can't escape my fate, Marley disappeared, and Scrooge went to sleep on top of his kid.
Do you need anything else out of these, Mom?
I'll just bring them out.
Now put them all in one box if you can, Joe.
Scrooge awoke with a start and looked around his room and heard nothing except the low, sad toll of 1 a.m. from the town to the
town.
Hey, yo.
Suddenly a strange figure stood by his bed. It shielded his eyes against the bright light. Coming from the crown on his head, I am the ghost of Christmas past, the crown spirit said. Who's past, Scrooge asked. Come with me and you shall see, the ghost replied. And he moved to the window ledge beside Scrooge's bed. Scrooge reached out and the ghost took his hand. And they began to glide through the skies.
You can throw the silver all on it.
Soon they came to rest beside a brightly lit window and they heard music and laughter on the other side. Look, the ghost said to Scrooge. And suddenly they're inside at the edge of lively Christmas party.
You look like you had too much eggnog. Dad's had too much eggnog. Hey, great.
Got run over by that thing.
You just pointed the young man back on the good woman in the center room. That's me, Scrooge.
Honey, what
was that
in the center room?
I remember her.
I'm cheating.
And do you remember that? I read it all. Do you remember this?
We got another
the ghost asked as he whisked it away. Now they stood in the corner of Scrooge's
office. In your toolbox.
Would you please not kick the edge of that?
Scrooge, a few years older, sat at his desk. The same young man stood beside him.
Wrong beast.
You'll never change, she whimpered as a tear trickled down.
Come on, how will you help
her face?
Yes,
you say you love me, but all you care about is your money.
Hang on.
Give her son.
She marched towards the door and looked back at the young Scrooge. I hope you're
making it. Come on, Window, throw some of this tinsel.
Because you'll have to enjoy it without me.
This is the fun part.
Hang on. No, Scrooge wailed.
Yeah, Happy New Year.
The girls lifted him away from his office.
Take care of her. You got a month ahead of time.
Never.
Wrong holiday.
That's our
money. Right, wrong holiday.
Hey, Window, you want to throw some of this?
Now, Scrooge was tossing and turning in his bed. I'm sorry. He sat straight up, rubbed his eyes, and
you want to head back to the house?
and a giant dressed in green velvet robe and sitting on a beautiful throne smiled at him with a lavish
banquet
table. I'll put it You know, the giant answered as he took a bite of a large red apple and began to back away. You're another ghost, the ghost of Christmas present, he said. He touches Scrooge's shoulder. Once they were on Narrow Street, crowded into a tiny, tumble-down house.
Oh, wrong giant.
This is a terrible neighborhood, says Scrooge. Get me out of here.
Do you need these nuts?
In time, answered the ghost. He led Scrooge to a small window of the house. Closes him. First look inside. Scrooge pierces through the window. Glass and saw Bob Cratchit at a simple table with five children. His wife stirred an iron pot hanging in the stone fireplace. Another child, younger and smaller than the rest, hobbled
to the table
on crutches.
Hey, do me a favor?
What are we having Christmas?
Could you carry this and follow me down the steps?
Asked old Tiny Tim.
Oh.
It will be a marvelous meal, Cratchit said to his crippled son.
Greg, you want to grab this big red one for me?
Yes.
The big red one?
Yeah, the big red machine in there.
The big red machine. The rolls. And for dinner, one piece of bright red hard candy for each of you.
Hang on. Let's get ready here.
Cratchit smiled at his family. We shall all be grateful.
I got the door.
To Mr. Scrooge for letting me spend the whole holiday at home with you, he said. Small voice.
God bless us, everyone.
The end.
That was wonderful, honey.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. 1999.